That. I want to get you more analysis on what the logic behind such an attack at this time would be and what implications that might have. CNN's Nic Robertson in London for you. Nic, if indeed this was a chemical attack, how does that play into the different sides' strategies, their war strategies on the ground?
Well, what we've seen is the Assad regime may gain sort of further north in the country. But if you go in and take a look at Damascus, this is where we've seen the strategy of the rebels change to a degree. And you look at the neighborhood here of Al-Ghouta, where this fighting has been going on recently since the end of July, more or less, and where this alleged attack took place. Go in again, and you can look at some of the smaller neighborhoods there, Kaboon, Jobar. Okay, why are these neighborhoods, why are the rebels trying to gain control here? Well, there are key roads that run through these neighborhoods, roads that link Damascus to the rest of the country. But what the rebels are realizing is they're not able to hold territory in some places. Homs, they're losing ground. Qusair, they lost that town. But if they group together, which they're beginning to do, different strategy, use more sophisticated weapons, that they can hurt the regime and consume the regime's troops in these neighborhoods inside Damascus. And that's where that fighting has been going on. And of course, consuming the troops means that Assad can't move as well. His forces in the north of the country, Aleppo, try to retake that. If you will, for example, up here, continue the fight around Homs. So a simple solution for that would be to use an area scale weapon like chemical weapons. It's alleged, the government denies it. The rebels say that's what the government did, but we just don't know the facts at the moment. But that's what's at play here. The rebels focusing on those areas of Damascus where they think they can make important strategic gains or at least hurt the regime where they're losing elsewhere, Becky.
Nic, there's been a lot of comparison between what's now going on in Syria and the Balkan War of the 1990s. You're, of course, someone who covered that war and a first-hand experience of it. I want to play a clip from a report that you filed in 2012 now for our viewers, where you talk about the Srebrenica massacre in July 95 and how that helped trigger international action in the Balkans. Let's just have a listen to this.
Srebrenica became an important catalyst for real intervention. Airstrikes stopped the Serbs in their tracks, reversed their gains. They sued for peace. So the question I ask myself, will Syria unfold like Bosnia? A slaughter so horrific, the world will have no choice but to take action. The experts are not so sure.
I used to believe that if there is a Syrian Srebrenica to go back to the Balkans, that we were forced, if you will, we were pushed into Bosnia by the horror of what happened in Srebrenica. I don't even know. If there is a Syrian Srebrenica, I'm not even sure we would come to the rescue.
In the 90s, Russia backed the Serbs. Today, it backs Syria. In the 90s, Russia was stumbling out of communism. The US overran their protests. Today, Russia is resurgent, rich in oil. It can and is ignoring the West.
How important, Nic, is it to engage with Russia over Syria now? The thorn in the Security Council side to date, of course. What's the chance they could help put an end to this war?
Russia can absolutely play a role in ending the war. And I think when I listened to that piece from last year, how much has actually changed on the grounds? Look, the dynamic has changed hugely. Qatar, that was backing the rebels, is sort of out of the game to a degree. Saudi Arabia more in the lead. Turkey, that was also assisting to the north, they are less in the game than they were before. You have Assad making gains in the north of the country. He's confident. His military leadership, many of them were killed last summer, but there weren't defections in the army. He thinks he's through the worst. The assessment of intelligence agencies seems to be that Assad is doing well here right now. So the whole thing has changed. The thought of a Srebrenica or an alleged chemical weapons attack making a difference now, that doesn't really seem to be the case. The international community is more looking at shaping a deal where Russia is heavily involved in that. We've heard these talks between Russia and the United States that may end up in talks in Geneva. Russia's going to be a big player in that, Becky.